During an interface with the Parliament's Committee of Finance, Samuel Were-Wandera, the Executive Director of Financial Intelligence Authority, revealed that the authority is working at conducting intelligence on all investors in the country because evidence has shown that some of them are fraudsters.
We did some analysis and we informed government that most of these investors who come and present fake documents to government, that they have financial resources and could undertake government projects. We discovered that most of these did not have any financial support in any financial institution globally, but they would come with fake documents. Some of them would work with the Minister of Finance, sign agreements, and this project stalled.
Wandera revealed that they carried out an assessment on credibility of 32 investors who purportedly wanted to invest over $1.9 trillion in Uganda, and they established that 90% were fraudulent.
In terms of value, when we assessed all the entities and companies which FIA was able to analyze, it was indicating about $1.9 trillion. Which they wanted to invest in this country. And through our analysis and report, we only advise the ministry or the agents of government which is seeking our support. Our role is advisory, and we give the facts as they are.
In the same meeting, Musasizi disclosed that the Financial Intelligence Authority has since February 2020 been working with the Financial Action Task Force in addressing the deficiencies in order to exit this grey list and the EU blacklist. He noted that there is hope that Uganda will be cleared in February this year.
I think all goes well because we have done all the necessary submissions. We have had an on-site and we are optimistic that this time round, good news will come in the February plenary sitting.
The minister has emphasized the need for Uganda to sustain the progress that has been attained in cleaning up its financial systems and ensure the robust system to facilitate effective implementation of the required anti-money laundering system.
The authority has over the years prioritized actions aimed at addressing the deficiencies identified during the mutual evaluation with a view of getting Uganda off the grey list and avoiding any future listing.
It's under the European Union, and then the grey list is somewhere else. Is the meeting for February going to clear us on both?
The Financial Action Task Force maintains a watch list of countries that have significant shortfalls in tackling money laundering, categorized under the grey list and the black list, and Uganda made it to that list in May 2020. And if the requirements are not fulfilled, it would affect the foreign direct investments because investors will not want to associate with countries where bringing in and taking out money is difficult and probably choose to stay away.
And because of this, we have a regional approach and we are monitored to ensure that there is no weak ends in the country which will attract criminals.
By March 2020, Iran and North Korea were the only countries on the blacklist, while the grey list has 24 nations, six of these found in Africa alongside Uganda, Burkina Faso, Mali, Morocco, South Sudan and Zimbabwe. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.